We will now formulate the clustering problems that we defined informally in the previous section as a rigorous computational problem. And I think good clustering should satisfy the good clustering principle, which says that elements within the same cluster should be closer to each other than elements in different clusters. Or, in other words, there should be a parameter delta such that distance between elements in the same cluster is less than delta, and distance between elements in different clusters is larger than delta. For example, is it a clustering satisfying the good clustering principle? Of course not, because there are elements in the same cluster that are further away from each other than elements in different clusters. However, this problem is easy to fix because here's the clustering satisfying the good clustering principle. And therefore, we come up with the following clustering problem. Find a partition of expression vector into cluster that satisfies the good clustering principle. But how about the example below this slide? Can we construct clustering satisfying the good clustering principle? It turned out that doesn't matter how much we try, there is no partition satisfying the good clustering principle for this dataset, which means that the problem that we just formulated, why it is a well-defined computational problem, it is essentially useless for most practical datasets because most of them do not have a partition satisfying the good clustering principle. Thus, we have to figure out how to construct a new objective function for clustering that will generate a solution for any dataset. Here is a small dataset of 4 points and 4 different ways to cluster it. Which of them is the best clustering? Our goal now is to come up with the notion of the objective function for clustering. And to do this, I will take a liberty to reformulate the goal of clustering into an equivalent goal of finding centers of cluster. For example, below you can see data set consisting of 8 blue points and 3 points representing centers of clusters for this data set. Our goal is to come up with the notion of distance between data and centers. And then, after we come up with the notion of distance between data and centers, we want to find centers that minimize this distance. But what is the distance from data to center? To define the notion of distance from data to centers, we will first define the notion of distance from a single data point to centers. And in this case, it's natural to define this distance as the distance from a data point to its closest center. For example, the distance from this blue point will be the distance to closest center, and we can construct distances to all for all data points in this way. Now, we only define the distance from a single data point to centers. Our goal now is to define the distance from all data points to center. What would be the natural notion of such distance? And I think maximum distance among the distances we just computed would be the natural notion of distance between data and center. That's how we define max distance objective function for clustering. After we define the notion of max distance, we are ready to formulate the k-center clustering problem. Given a set of points data, find k-centers minimizing maximum distance between data and center. You see at the bottom of this slide an example with 8 blue points and 3 centers. These 3 centers are very poorly chosen as a solution of k-center clustering problem. These centers would be a better solution. But is it the optimal solution of the k-center clustering problem? Actually not, because there is a different partition of points into cluster that gives even better solution of the k-center clustering problem. Anyway, it appears k-center clustering problem appears to be a rather simple problem, but it turned out that it's actually NP-complete. And Therefore, we have to develop an approximation algorithm for solving it, and our next task is to present case-centered clustering heuristic that is called the FarthestFirst Traversal. The FarthestFirst Traversal starts from choosing an arbitrary point as the first center of the cluster. At the next step, which point would you choose as the next center? The reasonable approach is to choose the point that is the farthest apart from the existing cluster, which will be this point. Afterwards, we find the distances from the already constructed clusters to all data points, and to choose the next cluster, we simply select the distance that is largest among the constructed distances, and this is our third cluster. If we only need to construct three clusters, we are done, and this is clustering, a partitioning of 8 points into three clusters that the farthest first traversal produces. Now, after we design the farthest first traversal algorithm, let's ask question, what is wrong with this algorithm in practice? Well, the farthest first traversal selects centers that minimize maximum distance. But biologists are often interested in typical rather than maximal distances because maximum distances often represent experimental errors or outliers. For example, in this case of a simple clustering problem that is presented below, let's see how human eye and farthest first traversal would solve the problem. The human eye will immediately see three clusters and will ignore outlier. The farthest first traversal, on the other hand, will always construct three clusters and miss the correct clustering of points. We therefore need to develop a different approach to clustering that works well with outliers. To come up with a new clustering approach, we first need to modify the objective function for clustering. Our max distance objective function designed for the k-centered clustering problem has its limitation. Please note that only one of distances shown below contributes to max distance. Instead, we will use a new objective function called the squared error distortion. The square error distortion is sum of squares of all distances divided by the number of points in the dataset. So, for the maximum distance, a single data point contributes to the objective function, while for the distortion, all data points contribute to the objective function. As soon as we define the squared error distortion, we define the k-means clustering problem. And the only difference between k-centered clustering problem and the k-means clustering problem is that the k-means clustering problem tries to optimize distortion rather than maximum distance. In this case, the centers chosen shown at this slide are not good centers, and after we apply k-centered clustering problem, they will move to different points. After we apply k-means clustering problem, they also will move to different points, and please note that they have moved to different position than in the k-centered clustering problem. Now, it may appear that k-means clustering problem is simple, but it turned out to be NP-hard even for partitioning a set of data points into just two clusters. The only case when there are polynomial algorithms for k-means clustering problem is the case when k equal to 1. You may think that there is no point to cluster datasets into one cluster because this clustering is given. Indeed, we are not trying to cluster dataset into one cluster. We are trying to find the best center of this cluster, and you will see in the next section that it will be actually very helpful. However, how do we find a center of a cluster? So how do we develop algorithm for k-means clustering when k equal to 1? When, in this case, there is the center of gravity theorem, which tells that the center of gravity of points data is the only point, remember, only is important here, the only point solving the one-means clustering problem. To remind you, the center of gravity of points data, if we represent every point as a vector, is simply the sum of these vectors divided over the number of vectors in the data sets, or in other words, the ith coordinate of the center of gravity is simply the average of the ith coordinates of all points in the data set. And now, after we introduce the notion of k-means clustering, we are ready to describe the Lloyd algorithm, the most popular approximation algorithm for solving the k-means clustering problem.